Hey you guys, welcome back to Thursday Thoughts. I'm Funky Like Feathers, and today we're gonna be talking about how you can get the most out of your life. If you like to reach your goals and accomplish all of your tasks, hit that like button. You're definitely in the right place. Let's get started on today's video. One way to get the most out of your life is to read. And when you read, try to get as much as you can out of those books, or if you work better with audio, get audiobooks. So one of the print books that I got, and I've talked about this book before, I'll leave a link at the top, is Tribe of Mentors by Tim Ferriss. Now, he didn't technically write this book. It's really a culmination of information from other influential people. There are 100 different people listed in here, people from all walks of life, every different possible scenario that they could have gotten into. But he asked them some very interesting questions. And there were a couple of people in here who answered a very specific question very similarly, and I kind of wanted to talk about that this week. So one of the people in this book, his name is Gary Vaynerchuk, and if you don't know who Gary Vaynerchuk is, I strongly suggest you look him up. He is one of the front runners as far as marketing and social media goes. He's very well known in the media and social world, especially when it comes to marketing and getting out there and pushing yourself farther than you ever thought possible. The other person that I'm going to talk about is Sam Harris. And Sam Harris is really big in the discussions and in theological arguments. He also has a podcast out. There are tons of different things that Sam Harris does. Sam Harris has written several different books. Gary Vaynerchuk, he's all over YouTube. These two guys are very influential in their fields. Seriously, give them a minute, go look them up, come right back. Then we can get started. Okay, so the question that both Gary and Sam answered is this question. What advice would you give to a smart, driven college student about to enter the real world? Now, this question really gets you started into thinking about what life advice would you give to people in order to get the most out of their life? And both Gary and Sam answered this question with about the same information. Now, Gary says it this way. He says, macro patience, micro speed. And he goes on to explain that they should not care about the next 8 years, but they should stress the next 8 days. All right, now we're gonna go over to Sam's answer and I'm gonna read that one to you. Sam has a very short answer on this. He said, don't worry about what you're going to do with the rest of your life. Just find a profitable and interesting use of the next 3 to 5 years. Now, both of these guys, if you listen to the premise of what they're stating that instead of looking at super long-term goals, that you need to look at the shorter term and what you can do now. Now, I also listen to audiobooks. Now, I am not affiliated with Audible in any way, but they really got a good one on this. Mel Robbins has several different books out. She wrote The 5-Second Rule. She also has one specifically for Audible called Take Control of Your Life. In this book, Mel Robbins talks about how to silence fear and start to win the mental game. And one of the concepts that she covers in this also reflects the same thing that Gary Vaynerchuk and Sam Harris kind of discuss. And that is to look at the more short-term goals instead of just the long-term. Now, these concepts really pull back into the reason that we plan so often. And just like I was talking about the new planner that I got, the Wordsworth planner, and I'll put a link up there for you. The Wordsworth planner also very much works with this same concept. Everything is goal-oriented, and in order to achieve those long-term goals, you really have to break it down into shorter-term goals. And not only about, you know, the overall thing, because when you have only long-term goals, everything seems so far away, and you really sit there in day-to-day, it doesn't seem like each day matters. You don't really have any drive every single day in order to reach that long-term goal. I really like how Mel Robbins, and I have this printout because when you download the Audible book from Mel Robbins, you actually also get a link to the PDF, and I went ahead and printed it out. So this is the PDF. It is 55 pages long. It is a workbook to go through and put your own answers while you make your way through the Audible book itself. In this packet, she really shows you how to break down those overarching goals into more tangible and bite-sized pieces. And so she literally is like, what's your, you know, major goal that you're working on? How can you break that down? And then how can you turn that into a micro goal? How can you really break it down to the smallest possible thing that you could do right now that could actually help you in that long-term goal? So those are some of the things I want you guys to think about this week. What kind of goals are you working on? Let me know down in the comments. I want to hear from you guys. There are tons of goals that we have in life. Some are super lofty. Some are very easy to get to. I hope you guys are having a great week. Let's talk about our goals. Let's make sure that we reach them, and let's make sure that we're working on them every single day. I hope you guys have a great weekend, and I'll see you again on Mean Muggin' Monday.